Happy Halloween, North. Welcome to our very first NTV show of the 2017-2018 school year.
We are thrilled that you are tuning in with us today, as we have a great show in store for you all. I'm Barrett Reese.
And I'm Anj Deshmukh. This is NTV. Some of you may be trick-or-treating tonight, but we really want you to have fun. But Jada Da Silva and Olivia Lasagna are here to share some safety tips with you to ensure that your trick-or-treating is not only a fun one, but a safe one.
Halloween is just around the corner, and everyone's getting excited for candy, costumes, and parties.
Although Halloween is supposed to be scary, it's also important to be safe. So here are some tips for a safe and fun Halloween.
Don't let random people into your house.
Trick or treat! I'm coming in your house now.
Okay.
Or just don't go into random people's houses. Be careful who you talk to on the street. It could be anyone under that mask.
When trick or treating, remember not to take any unwrapped or already opened candy. It could be dangerous.
Trick or treat!
Only take one piece of candy when the sign says only take one. You could end up getting chased.
We hope you will use these tips on October 31st.
Have a safe and fun Halloween.
This is Olivia and Jada
signing off.
Hey guys, today we're going to be showing you guys three easy DIYs to do for Halloween. Let's get started. For the first DIY, you'll need Kibblers fudge-striped cookies, white icing, and Hershey Kisses. For the second step, you'll need a plate to put your cookies on. Wrap your white icing and make a circle in the middle of each cookie. For the last step, take your Hershey's Kisses and place them on top of the white icing.
This DIY is a fun, spooky Halloween trick. The things you'll need is a large bowl, Sprite, sherbet, gummy eyes, or worm. First, we need to pour the Sprite into our bowl. After you pour it in your Sprite, add 5 scoops of sherbet. Now add your gummies into the drink.
Now it's time to mix it all together. And you're done.
For your strawberry ghost DIYs, the ingredients you're going to need are strawberries, white chocolate chips, and black icing. For the first step, you're going to rinse off the strawberries and cut off the top part of the strawberry. For the next step, you're going to grab your white chocolate chips and put them in a bowl, then put it in the microwave for 30 seconds. Then, you're going to mix the white chocolate chips until it's completely melted. After your chocolate is completely melted, you're going to grab your strawberries and dip it in the white chocolate. You're going to grab your strawberries and put them in the freezer for around half an hour. When you're done and the chocolate is completely frozen, you can start adding your faces onto the strawberries. And there you have it, your delicious strawberry ghost.
Simple Halloween DIY.
Have a great Halloween!
Bye!
This school year has brought many changes, and among those are several new faces on our North administrative team. Omar Ali, Ryan Sewell, and Rohan Gulati went and interviewed Ms. Kirby and Dr. Axelson to give them a warm welcome and find out a bit more about these fearless leaders.
Basketball, oh boy. I'd say the Dallas Mavericks. I'm not originally from Dallas. I'm originally from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. So my favorite football team is the Pittsburgh Steelers, for sure. As you can see, I've got some stuff up here from Pittsburgh. But in Pittsburgh, we didn't have a basketball team. So I'm happy to cheer for the local team. I do like the Mavericks, and Dirk is my favorite player. So after I got my bachelor's degree, I went back to college and got a master's degree. And after I was finished with that, I went back to college and got a doctoral degree. So doctoral degree is considered the terminal degree in most fields. It's, terminal means the end. It's the final degree that you can get. And so I sought a doctorate so I could learn as much as I can about working in schools and helping students and teachers. And once you earn that doctoral degree, you can use that title of doctor. Even though I'm getting gray-haired now, I still play soccer on the weekends, and I coach soccer. I have three little kids, and two of them play soccer, and I coach my daughter's soccer team. And also try to exercise, try to run, try to go to the gym and stay in shape. And you know, my life is pretty busy, being a school administrator and having children of my own. So I try to stay in shape, and those are kind of the things I do to unwind and have fun.
Maybe my like summer splish splash, but my weekending, no, probably not. What would I ban? People who don't know how to dab right.
Oh.
And also people who are unkind. I don't like unkind people. Ooh. I usually watch The Office. I do a lot of reruns of The Office. So
with the beginning of the new school year, we have many new 6th grade students. We decided to go around and ask them a couple questions on how they're liking middle school so far.
So, how are you liking middle school so far?
I like it. We get a lot of privileges.
I've been liking North a lot so far. It's just definitely a big change from elementary.
It's definitely a challenge for all of the due dates and homework, and just a big change from elementary school.
Alright, who's your favorite teacher?
Miss Park.
My favorite teacher would be Mr. Massengale.
My favorite teacher is Miss Mullen because she lets us reach for the first 10 minutes of class.
When you came to middle school, what was your biggest fear?
Well, I had a fear that I wouldn't be able to know my way around the school.
When I first came in, I was scared that I wouldn't make any friends or my grades.
I was scared if I was going to get lost.
Not being able to do my work, like falling back.
What's your favorite class?
Math and languages.
Probably social studies.
I'd have to go with math and discard it.
My favorite class is social studies.
That's a really tough question, but I think my favorite class is Students Art class.
So far, what would you rate middle school from 1 to 10?
8. I would rate it to a 10.
One thing you could change about North, what would it be?
I would change kind of a little bit of the lunch. Because the lunch is
maybe having an extra minute or so if kids have to complete something for their next class, they can get it done on time.
How are you liking the iPads so far?
Pretty good.
I love the iPads.
Well, that was all the time that we had for this interview. Thank you to all the 6th graders that participated.
In the fall of 1998, Coppell Middle School North opened its doors for the first time. That means that this school year marks the 20th anniversary for North. Olivia Lasagna and Jada Da Silva were able to talk to three of the original teachers that are still on staff with us today. Congratulations, Miss Reese, Miss Bottom, and Miss Williams for being Northeast then and now.
For many years, Coppell Middle School North has been the home of the Cougars. This year marks the 20th anniversary of our school.
Some of the teachers and staff have been here throughout North's entire 20-year journey.
Here's what some of the teachers that have been here the entire 20 years have had to say about how our school has grown.
What were one of your first few thoughts or things that went through your head when you walked into North?
Well, when I walked into North 20 years ago, first of all, the building wasn't finished. I didn't even have a doorknob on my door for about a week. And I already had students and classes, but I mean, this building was completely empty.
The building wasn't quite finished when we started. So there was plastic wrap on towards the F hall. You couldn't go down the F hall at all.
We didn't have a lot of stuff on the wall. The gym floors were not done. So all PE classes were outside. But it was really fun. You know, we went with what you had.
I'd say probably the biggest change has been technology. We didn't have email, and attendance was done on paper. If someone wanted to know what the homework was, they had to call a homework hotline, which was basically like a voicemail, and listen to it. So I'd say technology is probably the biggest change in the last 20 years.
What do you think has most improved about North over the years that you've been here?
Oh, that's a good question. Well, I'm not sure if it's really improved, but it's just every year the feeling of family gets stronger and stronger. Mm-hmm. And that to me is extremely important. So.
My favorite thing about North is the people. I really love the people here. And I love that we've had families that have come through. So I've taught, you know, 3 and 4 and sometimes 5 kids from the same family. And so that's really fun to have that history with families and get to hang out with people. I love the parents, I love the kids, I love the teachers. It's a great school to work at.
This is Olivia and Jada,
signing off.
Hey, you!
Who, me?
Yes, you! Do you want to learn how to trick-or-treat like a boss?
Yeah!
Here's the 3-step tutorial how to trick-or-treat like a boss!
Oh, yeah! Step 1, get a costume. Whoa! Let's go trick-or-treating!
It's time to stop!
Step 2, get a hoverboard. Get the best candy.
As we wrap up our show, we want to leave you with some Halloween spirit. Joe LaSalle and Jackson Kingsley and Victor Mesa put on together a music video just for your enjoyment, and we hope you appreciate this one as much as we did.
see something strange. Come with us and you will see. This our town of Halloween. This is Halloween. This is Halloween. Pumpkin scream in the dead of night. This is Halloween. Everybody make a scene. Trick or treat.
Tell the neighbors how you die of fright.
It's our town. Everybody scream. In this town of Halloween.
I am the one hiding under your bed. Teeth ground sharp and eyes glowing red.
I am the one hiding under your stairs. Fingers like snakes and spiders in my hair.
This is Halloween, this is Halloween, 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 Halloween.
In this town we call home, everyone hail to the pumpkin song.
Well, that's all we have for you today, North.
Please remember, everyone, to be safe as you go trick-or-treating tonight.
We hope you have a fun and safe Halloween, and we'll see you at school tomorrow.
This is NTV, signing off.
I wish I could be cool on Halloween.
Well, now you can. First, you'll need a mask. Next, you're gonna need a friend.
No.
Next, you'll need a recycling bin.
No.
So, Raj, what are your views on recycling?
I think that recycling...
So, Ms. Choi, what are your views on recycling?
They're great.
How do you feel about recycling?
I think it's great.
How do you feel about recycling?
Well, I think it's great.
So, Will, how do you feel about recycling?
I mean, it's great.
So, Max, how do you feel about recycling? How do you feel about recycling?
I feel like it's a...
What do you think about recycling at North?
I think it's very important.
So, David, how do you feel about recycling?
I think it's a good...